coverage you can count on.
The man who stole millions of dollars by scamming his own friends in the largest Ponzi scheme the state has ever seen was sentenced today. The judge called Doug Vaughan the most infamous criminal in New Mexico history, worse than Billy the Kid. Action 7 News reporter Alana Greenfogel was inside the courtroom. She joins us live from Santa Fe with more on this big story. Hi, Alana.
Hi, Shelley. Good evening. A handful of Doug Vaughn's 600 victims was here at the sentencing and told the judge Vaughn destroyed their lives, stole their life savings, and they're now living in financial despair, which they say are their own personal prisons.
I'm just sorry you didn't get more time.
Some of Vaughn's victims are elderly, some disabled veterans, and many Vaughn's own close friends who he lied to and stole $75 million from. The judge accepted a plea deal this afternoon, which meant Vaughn faced 10 to 12 years in prison. And the judge said Vaughn destroyed so many lives, calling him his actions despicable. And so he gave him the max, 12 years, as well as restitution, paying back his victims. But considering Vaughn is nearly 65 years old, and has some health conditions, attorneys on both sides don't expect him to survive his prison sentence, and so it's unlikely the victims will ever see a penny.
The tragedy here is that no matter what the sentence is, none of the victims are going to be able to recoup any of what they lost.
Mr. Vaughn's lost everything, and so I am sympathetic for the victims, and he's very sympathetic also. He's accepted responsibility for his crime.
He did address the court and tell the judge that today. Now, after the hearing, security officials escorted Vaughn out of the courthouse through a locked gate into the parking lot area, so he didn't have to face our cameras or answer any of our questions. He now has 48 hours to turn himself into the marshal's office, and his attorney says he will most likely be at a minimum security prison. Reporting live in Santa Fe tonight, Alana Greenfogel, KOAT Action 7 News.
Some victims told the judge they worried Vaughn had money stashed away for when he's released, but the prosecution says there's no evidence of hidden money.